Hello everyone, welcome back to Baaholic channel. I am your Monday educator Urpita Vishwas, and today I am going to discuss about the part 6 of digestive system, which consists the physiological activities in small intestine. So guys, let's start. This topic can be discussed through some subtopics, which are the functional anatomy, the secretion and motility of the small intestine, the functions of small intestine, and the last one, some applied aspects. So let us talk about the functional anatomy first. The small intestine is convoluted tube which extends from the pylorus to the ileocecal valve, where it joins with the cecum, the first part of the large intestine. It is about 6 to 7 meter in length, and it consists of mainly three parts: the duodenum, which is the first and shortest part of the small intestine, and the bile and pancreatic ducts opens here through the common hepatopancreatic ampulla of Werther on the postmedial wall of descending part of duodenum. The second one is the jejunum, and third one is the ileum. These two form respectively the proximal 2/5 part and distal 3/5 part of the remaining small intestine. There is no sharp demarcation between jejunum and ileum. Now let us talk about the structural characteristics of small intestine. Histologically, the wall of small intestine is made up of four layers, which from within the outwards consist of mucosa, submucosa, muscle coat, and serosa. There is presence of numerous folds of the intestinal mucosa. Those are pilic circularis. There is presence of densely packed villi and microvillus in the small intestine. And these villi have some numerous depression, which are called as the crypts of Leverkuhn. Now, in this diagram, we can clearly see many parts of the intestinal, small intestinal lumen: the absorptive cells, the capillaries, the artery, the presence of goblet cells, some intestinal crypts, some duodenal glands, lymphatic vesicles, and muscularis mucosa. There is also presence of microvilli, which contain some brush borders. These villi and microvilli increases surface area for absorption and also shows down the passage of contents through small intestine, which facilitate the absorption. Now, the villi are finger-like projections of mucous membrane that are seen throughout the length of small intestine. Each villus is covered by a single layer of columnar epithelial cells called as the enterocytes, and the core part of villus contains arterioles, venules, and fine network of nerves. During digestion and absorption, the villi contract quickly with an irregular rhythm and relaxation slowly. Their muscularis fiber serves to pump the lymph from the core of villi towards the submucosal lacteals. There is also presence of the crypts of Leverkuhn, which are the single tubular intestinal glands that invaginate deep into the lamina propria and present between the villi throughout the length of small intestine. And these glands are also lined by some columnar cells and contain goblet cells, which are mainly mucus secreting cells that can be seen among the epithelial cells of the mucous membrane. They increase in number as we pass down through the small intestine, and being few in duodenum and most numerous can be seen in the terminal ileum. Now let's move on to the secretion of small intestine. The small intestinal juice is known as the succus entericus. This comprises these sections. The epithelial cells of small intestine secrete aqueous components, which consist of water and some electrolytes. This watery secretion provides a solvent into which the products of digestion are dissolved. And the brush border of intestinal wall secretes intestinal enzymes, which have many types of enzymes. Number one is the peptidase that terminate the peptide to amino acid, the disaccharides, which converts disaccharides to monosaccharides, intestinal lipase, which acts on the triglycerides, and enterokinase, which activates the trypsinogen to trypsin. And the last one is the mucus secreting cell, which are the Brunner's gland. There is presence of two types of gland. Number one is the Brunner's gland and number two is the goblet cell. Both these cells secretes mucus. Now let us talk about the regulation of small intestinal secretion. This can be regulated through many mechanisms, mainly three mechanisms. Number one is the local stimuli. Mechanical and chemical stimuli goes to the intestinal mucosa, causes activation of myenteric reflexes, and this causes increase in enzyme secretion. Second one is the VIP, which is vasoactive intestinal polypeptide, that causes activation of crypts of liver cone and thus increases the enzymatic secretion. Three is the vagal stimulation, tactile stimulation, and some secretin hormone release that increases the secretion of Brunner's gland of mucus. Now, the motility of small intestine. This can be discussed in three parts. The interdigestive period. In this part, we can see the migrating motor complexes or MMC. This is one type of peristaltic web that goes through the esophagus throughout the GI tract, which causes sweeping out of chyme from the small intestine. This occurs in every 60 to 90 minutes and lasts for 10 minutes. Second one is the digestive period, which consists of mixing movement, that are the segmentation and pendular movement. The mixing movements of small intestine are responsible for proper mixing of chyme with the digestive juices. The number one type is the segmentation. This is the most common type of intestinal contraction, which occur throughout the digestive period in rhythmic fashion and hence also called the rhythmic segmentation contraction. This helps in the absorption of the intestinal food particles. The rate is about 12 times per minute in case of duodenum and 8 times per minute in case of ileum. This segmentation is mainly controlled by the pacemaker cell present within the wall of small intestine. Second type of mixing movement is the pendular movement. These are small constructive waves which sweep out forward and backward or upward and downward in pendular fashion. This can be noticed only by the close observation. The second type of movement is the propulsive movement, which are the peristaltic contraction. This refers to a wave of contraction preceded by wave of relaxation that help to propel the intestinal contents aborally and also help in digestion and absorption of the food particles. This rhythmic contraction is controlled by mainly through the enteric nervous plexus present in the small intestine. Some acetylcholine, nitric oxide and VIP also helps in the stimulation of this rhythmic contraction and relaxation. The peristaltic rush. This refers to a very powerful peristaltic contraction which occurs when intestinal mucosa is irritated intensely as in some infectious processes. And the last type of movement is the movement of villi. As the smooth muscle fibers of intestinal wall extend into the villi also, the movements of villi also occur during the movements of small intestine. This helps in the emptying of lymph from the central lacteal into the lymphatic system. So that's all about the digestive period, and the last is the motility reflexes. Number one is the gastroileal reflex that refers to marked increase in the peristaltic contractions of ileum associated with relaxation of ileocecal sphincter, which occur immediately after the meal. These are caused by the reflex stimulation of vagus and relaxation of ileocecal sphincter. The second type of motility reflex is the intestinal reflex that at the relaxation of smooth muscles of the rest of the small intestine in response to overdigestion of one segment of the intestine. Now the main functions of small intestine. Number one is the mechanical function. The mixing and propulsive movements of small intestine helps in through mixing of chyme with the digestive juice and propel it towards the large intestine. Second main function is the digestive function. Those are carried out by digestive enzymes present in the succus entericus, pancreatic enzyme and bile. Now the absorptive function. This can be done by huge surface area created by the presence of villi in the small intestine. This helps in mainly digestion of carbohydrates, proteins and fats and absorption of these final products. Hormone secretion. The small intestine secretes certain hormones like the gastrointestinal tracts. Those are the enterogastrin secretin and cholecystokinin. Some activator and protective function also can be seen by the small intestine. And last one is the hydrolytic function. The aqueous component of the succus entericus provides water and thus helps in all hydrolytic processes of enzymatic reactions of our digestive system of various food particles. Now the last part, the applied aspects. The paralytic ileus. This is decreased intestinal motility. Causes retention of contents in the small intestine, and this can be seen due to trauma, intra-abdominal operation and some reflex inhibition. The second type of problem is the intestinal obstruction. This can be seen in tumors, strictures, fibrotic bands in the abdomen, which is characterized by local ischemia, distension of gash, fluid and this causes pain in abdomen. So that's all for today. If you find this video helpful, please give it a big thumbs up and leave your comment below. And please share it. And if you are new on our channel, don't forget to subscribe it and hit the bell icon for further future notification. If you have any queries, please comment below, or you can also send your queries to our Gmail account, which is given in the description box. We will meet on next Monday with the 7th part of this topic, that is the physiological activities in large intestine. Thank you.